Hello, welcome to my channel. Here we are going to discuss about the second part of the tutorials and few more problems to be discussed under amplitude modulated wave, which can be applied for the communication or information theory papers. We'll take a problem which says about how to calculate total power if more than one modulation index is involved in the system. So how do we solve the problem? First, we'll read out the problem. Each and every word in the problem carries a message. So be careful in reading out the problem first. A transmitter radiates 10 kilowatt with carrier unmodulated. So the unmodulated carrier power is going to be 10 kilowatt power. And 11.5 kilowatt when it is sinusoidally modulated. So unmodulated you have one value, modulated signal output will have another value, 11.5 kilowatt. Calculate the modulation index if the sine wave resulting in 50% modulation is transmitted simultaneously. So here the word simultaneously means that it is there assumed more than one wave is transmitted. Okay, so you have to calculate modulation index if more than one wave is being transmitted with a 50% of modulation. And after that, you need to calculate total power radiated. So first criteria, you need to find out modulation index, assuming that two waves have been propagated. Okay, so we'll assume modulation index of the second wave, because you have given second part, so the second wave is 50% M2. The first wave is unknown to you. It is not given. Therefore, we'll take modulation index of first wave as M1. The total power has to be calculated, which is equal to PC into 1 plus M1 squared by 2. So you can find out, you can rewrite this equation PT by PC into 2, you are rearranging 2 plus m1 squared. Therefore, you take an LCM, so it will become 2, 1 m1 squared. This 2 will go to the numerator, therefore, you will get 2 pt by pc. So, what is m1 squared? We need to calculate modulation index first. Therefore, m1 squared is equal to 2 pt by pc minus 2. 2 I am taking it commonly out, therefore, pt by pc minus 1. What is pt? Modulated power. 11.5 kilowatt. What is PC? Unmodulated carrier power, 10 kilowatt. So, kilowatt gets cancelled. Therefore, 11.5 divided by 10, it will become 1.15 minus 1. Minus 1 will become 0.15 into 2. You are going to take square root of 0.3. The value of the modulation index of the first wave is going to be 0.55. Or the depth of modulation will be 55.5%. Now calculate the effective modulation, the total modulation. How many waves? Two waves. Therefore, the two waves will have an inducement to find out the total effective modulation index. The value can be calculated by this equation, m1 squared plus m2 squared. So if you have n number of waves, you keep on squaring that value and add that value, take the final square root. Therefore, first equation, M1, you have already calculated as 0.55. M2 is given as an alternative source of 0.5 modulation. They will square and you will get the new modulation index as 0.74. What is the second requirement? You need to calculate total power radiated. So, total power radiated, use the same equation. Total power is equal to carrier power into 1 plus effective modulation index. What is the effective modulation index? 0.74 from the recent one. Square the function, we divide it. Therefore, the value is 12.73 kilowatt power. So, it's not needed that whenever you go for a transmission, not even a single signal will be transmitted. More than one signal, even if it's transmitted, you can calculate what will be the final effective radiated power obtained from the transmitter segment. Only one thing you have to make sure that you have to calculate effective modulation index in this particular problem. Next, we move on to the similar problem, which says about, we'll consider an AM signal. It is generated by modulating a carrier. The frequency is 800 megahertz. We have a message signal output. Okay, the message signal is sine 300,000 pi plus 0.5 cos 5,000 pi. The AM signal output, so this is the transmitted output, is equal to 100 plus 1 of m of t cos omega ct. The output is taken across a load resistance. It's a DC output taken across a load resistance of 50 ohms. You need to determine what is the average power calculated in each and every bands and the carrier, and what will be the effective modulation index, and what is the peak power delivered. Okay, so from this problem, S of t is equal to 100 plus 1. What is m of t? Sine. Message signal m of t, sine 3000 pi. So substitute that value. Okay, cos omega ct. So this is message modulated with carrier. Therefore, the total output is the amplitude modulated output. So now you will have, what is the carrier frequency? 800 megahertz. Therefore, fc 2 pi fc, 2 into pi into fc will become your carrier signal frequency. It is taken across the resistive load, 50 ohms load. Now this is the generalized equation. Compare it with the given equation. Therefore, vc is equal to 100. What is ma1? First modulation index signal value 1. What is MA2? Second modulation index signal 0.5. What is omega m? First omega m is 3000 pi. Second omega m is 5000 pi. Now we need to calculate carrier powers. Carrier power equation is Vc squared by 2R. What is Vc? 100 squared. 2R is resistive load, 50 ohms. So 100 watts. Upper sideband, lower sideband. Since it is an AM wave, you will have three powers. Carrier power, upper sideband power, lower sideband power. Upper sideband power, usually it will be 4 times Vc squared by 4 multiplied. Therefore, it will become MA squared, Vc squared by 8R. What is MA? The modulation index value. I have taken it under 0.5 plus 0.5, 1. Therefore, 1 multiplied by Vc squared. 18 to 50 resistive load. Similarly, lower sideband also will obtain the same power. Okay, will obtain the same power. This is how we calculate the signal powers for each and every frequency spectra value. The second part of the problem says that you need to calculate the effective modulation index. We have two modulation index. One is 0.5, the next one is 1. So 1 plus 1.5, the total value will become 1.11. As of theory states that the amplitude modulated wave should have the modulation index at the maximum unity. If it goes above the unity value, we call it as over modulated, which means that distortions are present in the system, which is nothing but an external noise disturbance occurring in your ham radio. So that's how we try to tune your system in such a case that the modulation index should be always less than 1. Total power is called as also the peak power delivered to the system, which can be calculated from Pc is equal to 1 plus Ma squared. 100, what is Ma? Effective modulation index 1.11, square the value, rearrange the equation, calculate it. Therefore, the peak power is equal to 121.5 watts. So this is how we find out whether we have a perfect modulation, whether we have under modulation or over modulation. If it is over modulation, we can assume that the output will definitely end up in a distortion and your signals will be lost. In that case, we try to tune our system in such a case that we reduce the modulation index to be less than 1. Thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe for further updates on several tutorial sections on communication theory or information theory papers.